Now, what are the feelings?
I think feelings are the same. It's a great honor and a great recognition for our country. And the excitement now is the family and friends who are landing up there. That is the excitement. So we are busy organizing as to how do we get together, what do we do in between that hectic schedule out there. There are lots of people coming. My sisters are coming from all over the world. Four of my sisters are coming. Then Prasoon's kids and our wives and mother-in-law and sister-in-law that works and Pidlite, client Mr. Parekh and his family. So yes, it's a big jamboree.
Can
they have been kind to. We are all registered,
okay.
but the others are not. Others are not. No, they have been very, very nice on that, and they are going to see them very nicely.
And how big is the guest list?
I think there are 17 plus the four of us.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And our wives also insisting on you dressing up in a nice way, some designer clothes, something special for the occasion. I mean, even if you not, maybe women and sisters, wives and sisters will insist.
So, that hasn't changed in the last 50 years for me. They always think I'm not properly dressed, so they always insist that we dress up properly. So there is no, I'm not designer clothes in that scenario. But my dear friend Rajiv Rao's wife and my wife have collaborated to at least make me look sensible.
No, but no coordination between like what you will wear and what you will wear.
That they look like jokers if they look the same.
Same, some kind of preparation, rehearsals.
No, I am no rehearsals, no nothing. Just will I wear something which is a symbol of our country, I will, that you will see when I get there.
Thank you. Even I want to be, I just want people to know that I'm from the same country.
No, nothing better than that. But yes, it's going to be India on my heart.
So, sir, BP hasn't really come out with too many details about the entries they've set this year. But you did extremely well last year.
Yeah, we've done well over the years. And we never think about these things. You're competing in a scenario where you haven't seen other people's work. And I do not believe in predicting or hoping. We'll see what happens.
And for India, as in this year, you must have seen other people's work.
I don't know what people have entered, I think. Well, my suggestion to everyone has always been that go there, you've entered because you believe in your work. Never be too excited about it. If you win, celebrate. If you don't win, celebrate.
Yeah,
but aren't you going to ask him something?
No, I mean, I have similar questions for like the tips, something you want to talk
about. Because rebranding we can take separately
that's
later.
That's why I asked you. If
yeah, we can finish off this. I will go after this.
So, some kind of tips that you want to give to young creative advertisers who look up to you and aspire and want to win this one day?
No, I don't think you should aim to win a certain award. You should just aim to do what your heart tells you, what you genuinely believe in. This is not an award that you aim for. This is for your entire body of work over the years.
In terms of work, what do you advise? I mean, how should you approach creativity? What is wrong with the way youngsters are these days doing things?
No, I don't think there's anything wrong in the way they are doing anything. It is just that they need to be older. I think they need to respect themselves a little more. I feel sometimes queer people given too easily, okay, to a lot of pressures. You know, a lot of time when I'm reading the script, okay, and I feel this is extraneous, that is extraneous. This, if we remove everything, that soul is fantastic. And then later on, they tell me, well, that was the original idea. Then everybody kept coming in and adding a little bit. So be brave.
Split
split would be 95-5. If we are 90 and 10, the split would be 95-5. Their 5% commercials would be spectacular. They would bang on. But 95, if you go to US and just put on the channel, everything that you see is mostly trash. Okay? And when you put on any news channel here in India, there are more chances of finding something interesting.
Any country which is better than us, also, which you think is, does more than 10%, where you see the commercial?
Well, I think there are many countries who do good work. I think these percentages don't matter. I personally like a lot of work that comes out in the UK. I like work that comes out of Thailand. I like work that comes out of South Africa. And, you know, we South America, fantastic work from there. Japan does a lot of superb work. So I think it's not about countries. Little countries can surprise you. It's about people. And percentages won't matter. Somebody sitting in Sweden came up with an idea about Swedish tourism, which is mind-blowing. I mean, they might be having very little advertising as compared to others, but the Swedish tourism idea was something else.
Any ad that you have come across which you think should win a campus here? Indian ad?
No, it's very tough, you know, because that's a question every year people ask us. The problem is, because the media is so fragmented, at least I do not know what one is there. So a lot of
maybe has not gone any the best ad in your head this year that you saw on television and you felt that this is
predict on Canada. We never predict on Canada.
I think the big problem is what works for us. I am only interested in that. I think what works for me, say for example when I saw the Swiggy commercial with the gulab jamun, I said that's fabulous. Now whether it wins or it doesn't win, it's okay. You know, because somebody has to understand and appreciate how it works here, and you have to be, to be honest, do I understand and appreciate everything that happens, say, in Vietnam? I would not be able to. So it depends, you know, what kidney cheese, how much were they able to pick up, how much they could not understand. It's okay.
You know, earlier on you asked a personal question, I want to add to that about youngsters. I think one of the things that youngsters definitely should not get fooled by is awards. Just do work which is appreciated by people on the street, and some of which might end up getting an award. Don't work towards an award, it leads to nothing.
What's your favorite work of
this? But I think it would be Milesu.
That was in the 80s.
I've liked many, but you're asking me which is the most spectacular. And I think it is the most spectacular because it is, still then, everybody thought, see, it changed, it broke a lot of dogmas that were, you know, assumed in nationalism. It broke one dogma. There is no mention of country in it. There is no mention of India in it. It's fantastic. It's open because till then, all patriotic songs included Bharat, India, you know, whatever. This did not. And because he went for a larger thing of which is, you know, let your mind and my mind come together, okay, so that we are able to know. So what happens with that is everybody is able to read their own meanings in it. If a husband wife is not getting along, they find something to connect with in this song, you know. If a father and son is not getting along, they find something to connect, and actually it is operating on a much larger base, which is we as people, we need to come together. That's fantastic. So
basically it was Suresh Malik's idea. He was the one who got me to write the lyrics, and he's the one who told me you will not write a typical kind of a patriotic song. I do not want anything overt. I want, this is my idea. So I think that Milesu is very close to me also, but it's Mrs. Malik.
Lyrics writing between you and
keep writing
maybe
lyrics.
Maybe I'm not aware of any good romantic songs. You only write patriotic songs or songs that get you commercial.
Yes.
You don't share that, those romantic songs.
I don't write for movies. We write a number of things for our clients. So that's good.
But you only write for clients. You don't write for yourself. Something that you write for yourself and you.
I write a lot for myself, one day you'll see it.
Okay, I'm really waiting to do. Now, what is your favorite work?
I think undoubtedly is the huge body of work that we did for 5-6 years for Times of India. A Day in the Life of India. And out of that superb lot, it's difficult to choose. But the commercial about the file, to me, is probably the best commercial India's ever done, because it has fantastic take on the state of affairs. It's about corruption, and end of the commercial, you don't know whether you want to laugh or you want to cry. It's tremendous piece of work.
What more do you want to do other than advertising, lyrics, right? Things that we know you can do. Something that you've been wanting to do.
I want to travel India all over again. I've been threatening my wife for a long time that I'm going to take 3 months off and I'm going to take my driver and I'm going to drive around the country, see places which I still haven't seen actually quite a bit. Because there's so much to learn from a country. And Northeast particularly, I haven't done very much. I want to do that.
Well, there's a lot for me to do. I've only begun.
But still, like, apart from what you are doing very well and we know you do, I mean, things that some hobby or some passion that
I got lots of hobbies, lots of passion. I do all of them. I don't work as much as you think I must be working. I do lots of pretty things. I build, I break, I make. Lots of passion.
He's a designer by education. Here is by both our NIT people.
In fact, first building some institute you went to, you didn't like the design and you said you're not going to study here.
That was an architecture school. I didn't join architecture because I didn't like the bit.
Yeah. That's not the logic most youngsters have.
I think if I don't
see luxury, it was cynicism. of saying I don't like, so I wouldn't do.
Also, to be fair, I'd already, by that time, I'd seen an idea. So I knew where I wanted to go. If I didn't have another option in hand, I wouldn't have given up this.
You've done some acting
assignments. People make a mountain out of a moat. I did a very small part in my friend Shujit Sarkar's film, only because he insisted that I didn't have to act. No, I always.
You were the cabinet secretary.
I was the cabinet secretary. I actually asked the government one day, do you have a post of acting cabinet secretary? They said, no, there's nothing as acting cabinet secretary. I said, in that case, I'm the only one because I was acting as the cabinet secretary. Basically, we'll look forward to seeing you again.
Yes.
And let's all have fun.